we're asked to represent the inequality y is greater than 5 on a number line and on the coordinate plane. So let's do the number line first. Let me just draw out a number line. That's my number line, all the possible values of y. Let's make that 0 on the number line. We could obviously go into negative numbers, but we're going to be greater than 5, so I'll focus on the positive side. So let's say that's 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, and then that's 6, 7, so forth, and so on. And this number line represents y. And y is going to be greater than 5, not greater than or equal to. So we're not going to be including 5 in the numbers that can be y. So we're not going to include 5. So we're going to do an open circle around 5. And all of the other values greater than 5 will be included. So if there was a greater than or equal to sign, we would have filled it in, but since it's just greater than, we're not including the 5. So that's, we've represented it on the number line. So let's do the same thing on the coordinate plane. So let me draw coordinate plane here. And just using the standard convention, that is my y-axis right there. And then the horizontal axis, I'll just assume is my x-axis, is my x-axis. And let me draw some y-values, positive y-values. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. That is 5 right there, and you go 6, 7. You can just keep going into larger and larger numbers. And we want y to be greater than 5. So it's not going to be greater than or equal to. So we're not going to include 5. So at 5, at y is equal to 5, we will draw a dotted line. That shows that we're not including, that shows that we are not including y is equal to 5. But we want to include all of the other values greater than 5. So that we will shade in. So here we have shaded in all of the values greater than 5. If it was greater than or equal to 5, we would have drawn a bold line over here. So no matter what x is, no matter what x we pick, y is going to be greater than 5.